up there is just about a half moon. Now, when the moon is within a half, we can work out the relative distance from the Earth to the moon and the Earth to the sun. So looking over that way, you can see the sun. And because the moon is about as a half moon like that, so we're only seeing exactly half of it, and you've got the sun over here and then the Earth's down here, that means that the angle between the Earth and the moon and the sun is 90 degrees. Now, if we could stand here and measure the angle from the Earth to the sun and the angle from the Earth to the moon, that's this angle here. If we could measure that angle, that means we know all the angles in the triangle. If we know all the angles in the triangle, that means we know the relative distances. So this distance is one astronomical unit, and this distance is the distance from the Earth to the Moon. And this was actually done in 300 BC. We're able, by measuring that angle, to get the relative distance from the Earth to the Sun and the Earth to the Moon. And the conclusion was a little bit out. It's actually 400 times further away, and the measurement in Greek times was 20 times further away. And it's because it's measuring this angle is so hard to do. So we could draw some lines on the ground and then point to that one and get the angle, but it's very hard to get exactly right without telescopes. Isn't that cool?